प्लीज जॉइन अस देयर निशान यू टेक द स्टेज या एक्टर्स आर ऑलवेज फिटर देन अस रेगुलर पीपल या Sanjay Gupta is also meant to join us from Star, but I think he's stuck in the infamous Pune traffic, which we are learning to. Thank you so much, guys. I hope everyone's eaten. I think Nikhil was very smart to keep the stars of the day towards the second half, because the boring editors were in the first half, and then everyone could eat and get a nap and then be ready for.
No. The thing was, he knew ki we guys don't wake up early.
Yeah, see? So, Vishal has, to any cricket fan, can this be heard? Yeah. Vishal, to any cricket fan off late, has become a bit of a, you've become a very, very, very famous, popular person around India now. Yeah? Do you kind of get annoyed sometimes when you're walking around the street and they go, Arre yaar, mauka mauka wala banda, ye bas, that's what we know him as. You're almost your own identity is gone. You've become that guy.
I would say ki it started off like that only, mauka mauka wala. But I played smart. I was telling him also abhi khate vak. So I played smart a little bit during the World Cup when all the interview sessions were going on. I came as a real me instead of real me. So many of them know me as a real me, like Vishal Malhotra as well. So yeah, sometimes, but yeah, mostly they they recognize me as mauka mauka only. But no. It has given me a great identity, great recognizability and everything. So, I am happy. Yeah, nothing as such. It's no crazy tension here. It's a good one. Obviously.
Vikas comes from the same part of the world as Virat Kohli.
Vishal.
No, I know. But you come from the same... Vikas is his older brother's name. Virat's elder brother's name is Vikas.
Okay.
Vishal comes from the same part of the... So, my sentences are getting mixed up.
That's why you were asking me. Either. Okay, yeah.
So, same area. You are very much a quintessential Delhi boy from that that part of the city which is known to have a robust, fun-loving culture.
Obviously, yes. Yeah. Stayed over there for like maximum part of my life up till now.
Yes, now you are very much a Bombay boy. But you know, before we talk a little bit more with Vishal, let's actually see the campaign. This was the one that got you all the girls chasing you.
Haan, yeah? They came and there were few ads which were showing me my dimple with Harsha Bogle sir and Shoaib Akhtar sir as well off screen and Mr. Akash Chopra, he'll be coming tomorrow.
Yes.
So during when we were shooting of that days and dimple were there, so during the streets when you were shooting. So they were coming and I used to say ki nahi nahi nakli mooch hai it's a fake mustache mat pakdo nikal jayegi dheere dheere kyunki mooch itna zyada you know you're not bound to open your mouth that much.
let's have a look
what I mean about Javed and the opposition. It never stops. It's not wise to
aaj chal ke dar pe aaya hai mauka mauka कब
इंडिया वर्सेस पाकिस्तान छठी बार आईसीसी क्रिकेट वर्ल्ड कप 15 फरवरी स्टार स्पोर्ट्स नेटवर्क पर
कब फोड़ेंगे यार
अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फॉर दैट ग्रेट वर्क
नाइस यप
टेल मी कैन यू टेक अस बैक टू द स्टार्ट ऑफ व्हेन दिस आइडिया वाज फर्स्ट थ्रोन टू यू कैन यू टेल अस द बैक स्टोरी व्हाट हैपेंड
सो व्हेन आई वाज कॉल्ड एंड आई गॉट फाइनलाइज्ड So we had a meeting and the briefing was done with star people were there and at that time nobody from the star briefed me about that but yeah the director was there so this was directed by Mr. Suresh Triveni he's a wonderful guy so when I was briefed I met in like Juhu office mein around 11 o'clock in the night so we were working on the various looks actually which most people doesn't know is this ki this ad shows the timeline of three, not generation, I would say, but kind of. Like the young guy, college one, 91. After that, the guy, the same guy which got married and like expecting a baby. And then the middle-aged guy. Not so middle-aged, but love kind of. So they were being played by three different people
right.
in that.
Okay.
So three actors were chosen, like lookalikes. So I was being selected for the second one. The married one and the expecting a baby. But at something, good things happen. And
you look young enough to play the young guy.
Not the college one, but at that time, the director, we called the makeup guy and we were finalizing all the suitable mustaches which can give me different looks. Yes. They got me shaved like twice. I got rashes on my beautiful skin, whatever. So, sab acha acha we did. Fir uska bhi final hai ki chalo, all the roles will be played by me only. I was happy getting a good amount then. Money was increased. Fir uske baad, we started shooting at 7 in the morning, next day.
So, basically, you got paid for 3 people. No, I mean,
अरे मेरा bank account का ledger लेकर आओ.
चलो, carry on.
So, it was, but at that time, money was not much, which I got, I would say. Chalo, anyway, start that.
Nikhil will pay you more than this for this appearance, but tell me, carry.
I hope he does. So, acha, so the brief which came was ki, I saw it just as a normal, as an actor, I just pursued it as a, theek hai, ek alag se, we are getting it a work, and this ad was supposedly be to be done on 14th Feb, 14th ke baad, 15th Feb or something like that, after Valentine's Day, ek or do din baad, when the India-Pakistan match was there for World Cup. Because that, obviously, is a sensational thing we have. India-Pakistan, dusra World Cup hai, and at that time, Mr. Amitabh Bachchan was also in some part of the commentary. He was coming onto the ground for promoting his film. So these were the few things which got so much hyped up. So that was the thing they forced them to bring it, and that particular thing. So, uske baad,
so it was put out earlier than it was first thought. Was really,
we can say so.
Yeah?
We can say so. And uske baad, we were shown that I'm a guy, I'm a Pakistani cricket team fan, who's playing a fan from the young days.
Yes.
But he doesn't get the occasion of like bursting crackers. Crackers was the idea which was there, and that it was the internal cricket creative team of Star only who got this conceptualized. And this was the team, because in India or Pakistan, we were like, both are the same genre only, if I say the roots are the same. So yeah, so what that does is ki patake phodne is something like we have a tradition.
To celebrate.
Yeah,
to celebrate.
So that was the thing they brought it up over here. And ki ye patake nahi phod pata every time. So he is expecting ki chalo ab hoga. And so that was the concept. And actually it was like motivating Indian cricket team only, but from the other side. So this was the unique idea. So we did. Nothing as such or something. I laughed. Jab director told me, ki, hum dono has rahe the. We were sharing a fag of smoke or bus. We laughed or achha tha. Chalo, theek hai, start done. Next day we shot. This ad was shot in 2 days. We shot for 2 days for this particular, this one. And I guess mere khayal se kuch, first week was there. In like after 3-4 days when it got on air, it was played for 6 days before the match, till the date of the match came. 6 days it was played on air, and after the match, suddenly all over the net, all over the internet, a huge hype came, and I was there with everyone, with OLX and all the cheesy and mimicky things were there, ki ab to pod de, ab to bhej de, wagaira, wagaira. So these mimics helped it actually. It created a buzz. Then they decided to go it further, and they made another ad for like each match India was playing against.
So can you tell us, Vishal, whether, because there is a Champions Trophy match coming, India-Pakistan, acha, nahi batauge? Okay, so sometimes you have to read between
there
the lines.
There
exclusive information available via this, that something may be in the works.
Maybe.
But
maybe.
He is not telling us. Okay, let's go back to you doing this.
Okay.
So, can you narrate your experience of what you first thought when you, I mean, you're a professional actor. You get given scripts all the time. When you saw this script, were you like, yeah, yaar, yeah, this
so
will
for
work.
This thing, for this thing, as I said, the director, I was working with him for the first time. The best part was, I was never given a script. For this first ad, let's talk about with the first ad first. So, iske liye kabhi no script was given. He just told ki kya kya momentos chal rahe hain. Wo nahi phod pa raha. अब एक कॉलेज वाला लाइक यू नो 91 आया, उसके बाद 95 वाला आया, ही इज इनटू कॉलेज, छोड़ दिया थोड़ा, जॉब वॉब है, बॉडी बिल्डिंग वाला, आई हैव फ्यू मसल्स, तो थोड़ा दिखाते हैं वगैरह वगैरह. तो इफ़ यू जस्ट नोटिस, तो बोलना नहीं चाहूँगा बट आई अब्यूज इट असली में उसमें, जो पटाखे फेंक रहा है. तो
ठीक है, वेयर वी कम फ्रॉम इन दिल्ली, अब्यूजिंग इज क्वाइट नॉर्मल यार.
इट केम, या नॉर्मल थिंग है, कोई बात नहीं, अच्छी बात है. तो फ्रस्ट्रेशन वैसी आती है ना, क्या करें. चलो, तो दैट वॉज द थिंग. फिर उसके बाद तो ही जस्ट ब्रीफ्ड मी ऑल द scenarios which are happening. So nothing, a proper script wasn't there actually.
Right.
They just had an idea. We were just making an idea go work.
Did you see the final product before it went on air?
During dubbing, yes. During dubbing I saw. And the most interesting part is that it is just not the, it was the first ad, sorry. After that, which all the other ads which came, we had the losing cases also, along with the win cases. Hopefully we played all the win cases. Because, but losing case was also more interesting, and we had that. And I used to watch that during dubbing, obviously.
So you are a cricket fan?
I am. Hamesha se rehte hain, sabhi rehte hain. But yes, I became like on a higher note, I became after working on these projects. Because I used to go to the Star Sports office every day. Be with Mr. Bhogle, with Mr. Shoaib Akhtar, and then Mr. Akash Chopra, and sabke saath. Roz. So you get that in mind, or fir karte, you adapt that things.
Okay. Now can I ask you, you know that this ad became very popular in India, but it also generated a lot of heat in Pakistan, where a lot of Pakistani fans, I remember going then on the internet at that time and saying, you know, this is a little bit of an insult to us. After all, iske beech mein kai matches hue hain jab Pakistan ne India ko haraya hai. If you, agar aap overall record dekho, to Pakistan's record is better than India. It's only like coincidental that World Cups mein India has never lost to Pakistan. Did you also get a lot of reaction from Pakistan? Can you give us some stories of what it was like?
I used to get, I never visited Pakistan. Though I had an event calling thing at that time. Like I was, after the shoots, I used to go for different places for the interviews. At a certain, like after 3-4 ads we did. So during that Pakistan also there was an event which called, but I never took it seriously actually. Pata nahi, I never felt like going, or kabhi gaye bhi nahi, I don't know. So, but yes, on Facebook and different posts which I used to see, then on Twitter or in sab pe jab aaya, to there were few posts which were criticizing, but on the same end, I would say ki mostly were the ones, they were taking it very sportingly. They were saying ki achha hai, achha hai.
So jo criticize karte the, unko aap kya bolte the?
मैं रिप्लाई नहीं करता था. जो अच्छे वाले थे उनको लाइक कर देता था थम्सअप. जो क्रिटिसाइज भी करते थे, इफ दे वुड बी अ वेरी अच्छा वाला यूनिक कंसेप्ट से करते था तो उनको स्माइली या लाइक, उनको भी थम्सअप कर देता था. बाकी नेवर रिप्लाइड मच.
नाउ दैट यू हैव बीन इन्वॉल्व इन द क्रिएटिव प्रोसेस इनटू समथिंग लाइक दिस, एज एन एक्टर यू हैव ऑल्सो सीन की स्पोर्ट बिकम्स समथिंग विच इज वेरी पैशनेट, पीपल गेट वेरी इन्वॉल्व. डू यू थिंक समथिंग लाइक दिस विच इज ह्यूमरस, क्लेवर, can help make these rivalries a little bit less kind of intense and people can enjoy themselves more, because after all it's a little bit of fun, you know, sports should be fun.
Obviously, take it as a game. We all know that. We all in our brain know that. But kya kare? Beat you, beat me, beat anyone. Jab phir India-Pakistan match chal raha hota, toh we don't take it as a game. Behind the scenes, जब टीवी के सामने हम लोग होते हैं तो वी डोंट टेक इट एज अ गेम. तो वो कहीं ना कहीं वी हैव दैट थॉट. बट एनीवेज, लेकिन इट्स अ वंडरफुल थिंग एंड एक्चुअली एंटरटेनमेंट, स्पोर्ट्स इन एंटरटेनमेंट एंड स्पोर्ट्स ऑन सेलुलॉइड लाइक वी हैव इन मूवीज नाउ और ये सब, इट हैज टेकन थिंग अ लिटिल फॉरवर्ड विद, यू नो, ओपनिंग ऑफ द, ब्रॉडनिंग ऑफ द होराइजंस, ओपनिंग ऑफ द माइंड फ्रेम्स, एंड एवरीवन इज नाउ अटैच्ड विद इट, एंड एवरीवन इज रिलेटेड टू स्पोर्ट्स सम वे ऑर द अदर. ठीक है, हम भी नहीं है तो ठीक है, जो हमारे मम्मी पापा है, हमारे जो उनके जो बच्चे, हम लोग हैं, मैं आप लोग सब में नहीं जाऊंगा, बट दे वॉन्ट कि चलो स्पोर्ट्स में जाए, चाहे वो नहीं खेलते, तो एवरीवन कहीं ना कहीं दे आर एसोसिएटेड विद स्पोर्ट्स.
सो देयर विल बी अ वर्ल्ड कप इन 2019,
राइट?
हां, यू विल बी इन डिमांड देन. Then you can ask for the price of not three people,
ten
people.
I was in demand for T20 last year also.
Huh.
Maybe Champions Trophy, I don't know about that.
Okay.
Hope so for T20 next year 2018, then World Cup 2019.
Okay. So this has changed. This has changed your life.
It has. In professionally, yes, it has. And personally level also, obviously more of recognizability we have. Who doesn't like to get noticeable and everything? But yeah, professionally, obviously, I got scored few good things after that. I was leading a show, Abhi Star Plus Pe. I got that. I got few movies. Sanamre was there. 1920 London was there. I was part of those movies.
So
also.
The Mauka Mauka yeah. guy has become that much more popular after
going on. The journey yes. is still going on.
Which of these three people? Well, you played a guy at different stages of his life. Which of them did you relate to the most?
Which I relate the most? जो बीच में था कभी कभार इरिटेशन फ्रस्ट्रेशन में और
गाली देने वाला
कभी कभार और द लास्ट पार्ट जो था उसका द मिड एज वाला आई वुड से दैट क्योंकि गोइंग फॉरवर्ड वी कुड यूज ओनली दैट टाइमलाइन
यस
बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली जब ईयर आ गए लाइक 2011 में ही वाज लाइक दैट तो गोइंग फॉरवर्ड ही विल बी प्लेइंग द समवेयर ऑफ द दैट वन ओनली तो ठीक है बीइंग ऑनेस्ट टू माई वर्क ऑब्वियसली मैं उससे रिलेट करूंगा And that was the only point जहाँ पे मैं पूरे में कुछ बोला कब फोड़ेंगे और बाकी मैं तो सिर्फ रिएक्शन देता उसमें कुछ बोला एंड दैट गाय अब जैसे T20 वाला था तो उसमें भी वी रैन अ शॉर्ट कैंपेन सम मिस हैपन थिंग्स कुछ हो गई थी जो भी है तो छोटा सा कैंपेन हमने चलाया था Feb 2016 T20
के
एंड दे वर ऑल्सो गुड और इसमें जब वो दिखाया मिड एज वाला ना तो दैट सेम थिंग डायरेक्टर विच ब्रीफ मी वॉज की जस्ट लाइक जैसे पाकिस्तान माई रूट्स आर फ्रॉम उस वक्त व्हेन पाकिस्तान वाज इन इंडिया तो सब उधर के ही हैं ग्रैंडफादर्स और वगैरह सब
तो वो जो असली में जैसे पंजाबी व्हेन दे सॉ यू प्ले अ पाकिस्तानी फ्रस्ट्रेटेड पाकिस्तानी
देखो घर वालों का अपना बच्चा होता तो अरे टीवी पे अरे भाई यार नाइस सब आ गए और दिल्ली है तो आई एम फ्रॉम दिल्ली तो उसमें जो फिर पड़ोसी होते हैं आई लिव इन अ लोकेलिटी फुल ऑफ पंजाबी तो सारे वही होते हैं उनते बगल वाला प्लॉट भी ले लोगे मल्होत्रा साहब मतलब साइड वाला प्लॉट भी खरीद लिया होगा ये भी मतलब दे थिंक की यू नो एवरी डे इन द न्यूज पेपर यू आर कमिंग एवरी डे इन द न्यूज यू आर कमिंग तो बस यू आर डन तो ये रिएक्शन होते वैसे बट या दे वर हैप्पी ऑब्वियसली और किसको नहीं उनको फिर इससे नहीं पता फर्क पड़ता पाकिस्तान है इंडियन है बांग्लादेश है बट नॉट टू स्पेसिफाई पाकिस्तान अगेन एंड अगेन दिस वाज द फर्स्ट एड क्योंकि हमने शुरुआत इससे की लाइक आई वाज प्लेइंग द पाकिस्तानी उसका सेकंड एड आया फिर साउथ अफ्रीका वाज नॉट देयर थर्ड एड आया दुबई यूएई वाला आया उसके बाद बांग्लादेश वाला आया सब आया तो आई वाज गोइंग इन एवरी जर्सी कि कहीं भी मैं जाऊंगा आई वुड एज अ कैरेक्टर आई वुड से कि कहीं भी मैं जाऊंगा किसी भी टीम से जाऊंगा बस हाँ इंडिया हारे और मैं अपने पटाखे फोड़ू दिस वॉज दिस गाइज एम जो कभी होता नहीं हो भी ना अच्छी बात है बींग ऑनेस्ट टू माई सिटीजनशिप भी और अकाउंट वाइज
अगर पटाखे फट गए तो फिर एड की तो वैल्यू नहीं रह जाएगी ना गुड जॉब विशाल वंडरफुल इट वॉज वेरी एंटरटेनिंग एंड आई थिंक यू डिड अ ग्रेट जॉब यू डिजर्व अ राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज फ्रॉम एवरी वन Here, his one's been patiently listening. Actually, we can just listen to him. There's not a lot. Yeah, if we can pass the mic on. He's been part of creating something which was captivating and something that was in a different genre to what Vishal did. But let's have a look at it first and then we'll chat sure. about it. Yeah, here we go.
All systems on go, cause I got goals and I won't take no for an answer. Got the grace of a dancer, the heart of a panther. I don't understand you. It puts in your vocab, I cannot quote that. I want this so bad, I cannot go back. I cannot back down, I will not give up. You versus me, huh? I say good luck. You don't want this problem, cause I don't do it unless I go full throttle. And I might throw it on Instagram, just to show you what the difference is. For instance, I'm up with the roosters, I'll run the runners, I'll shoot the shooters. In the mirror, hey girl, let's do this. My only competition is myself. That's why I keep some trophies on the shelf. Never lazy, cause it's bad for my health. Da da ding, da da ding. Bada boom, bada bing. Now let's go. Turn up the dial. I'm in the gym making me proud. Then I'm on the track holding it down. Know where my girls at? Let's go. I'm gonna show the world that anything they could do, we could do better. Just do it.
Well, I mean, it moves you. It celebrates the female athlete. I don't think anything has in India in the past. Can you talk us through how this came about?
Wow. Okay. So I think there were many layers to this problem. I think when Nike came to us and told us that we want to talk to girls, we got incredibly excited because it was our chance to show girls in a way that they've never been shown before. Yeah. And we had to do this to an audience who've been actually discouraged from playing sport. There were so many things working against it. I think what we realized very quickly was that sport has a very massive image problem over here. There's just cricket, and then you have, like, with all due respect, you know, the stories of athletes who, like, suffer and then make it to the top. These are the only two sort of narratives that exist. There's a whole layer below that, and no one actually talks about them, represents them. And what it actually ended up doing was alienating sport to a large audience, especially to girls. So girls are told not to go out and play. Don't damage your skin, don't get a tan, you won't get married, who'll marry you, which really does my head in. So it was almost like a personal mission as well, because you can go out, you can play, you can be successful, you can be beautiful, you can be all of those things at the same time. And I think we were just pushing back on so many layers of cultural sort of obstacles and, like, all the bullshit, you know, like people say about, like, girls going and playing sport. So it came from a very personal space, and then we said, we need to make girls feel like they can play sport. Sport is for them. We have to make it cool. We have to package it in a new way, because obviously the old methods were all sort of dying and no one was actually picking up a sport. We said, how can girls actually feel like sport is for them, and how can we help them go out there and actually play? So this is a response to that.
You will know the answer to this, obviously. How many professional athletes are involved in this video?
Well, I don't know the exact number, but I think it's about, we've got Rani Rampal, who's obviously the national hockey player. We've got three cricketers. We've got Deepika, who used to play badminton, yes. And we used her in that capacity.
Yes.
With obviously the layer that with sport you can be a star, and you can be a national football player, and you can be just another girl running on the street.
That's right.
The point of the sport was to put all these girls on an equal footing, because once you go out on the basketball court, on a tennis court, you're not a star, you're not nobody, you're just a player who can hit a ball really hard, or you're a player who can either score 3 points in a slam or a slam dunk. On the field, no one cares who you are. So that was the thing, really, and we said, we can't make another Nike ad. Nike ads, everyone expects a certain kind of Nike ad. We had to be, we always have to have the pressure to sort of surprise, to be ahead of what people expect of us to do. And so we said, like, there's this whole world of girls who are doing amazing things around the world in pop culture, MIA, Beyonce, like the way they project themselves, the way they talk about themselves. We said, we have to do a music video. We have to create a track that lives on girls' phones. It has to be on your phone. If it's on your phone, it's there for 2 weeks. Campaigns get lost, it dies, everyone forgets about it. But like as recently as 3 weeks ago, it was on the iTunes, on the iTunes workout playlist. So for us, like all of these things were like super important in talking to girls in an absolutely new and fresh way.
Let's talk about the creation of this from start to finish in some ways. Can you first talk about you mentioned the music gets you immediately. You don't have to watch it, you just feel the rhythm of the music, you just hear it. How was that created, and kind of the backstory of that?
I think it was very clear that music was number one priority, getting that right. You know, so here's how it works. Like when directors make music videos, they only make music videos to tracks that they like. If they don't like a track, it doesn't matter if you're Michael Jackson, directors will say, no, I won't make this music video. So it was very important for us to like the track, and for the director to be invested in it, and it was a collaborative process. We spoke to some of the best artists around the world. We spoke to about 20, 30 artists. They had a lot of tracks. We were really spoiled for choice. But we were chasing a sound that was not familiar. So this track, although it's powerful, it doesn't sound like an EDM track that you hear in a club or like another track that you hear in the gym. Yeah. It's got its own texture, it's got its own sensibility, and it's actually by a producer who also produces songs for MIA. So we said, we have to push things. We can't settle for a pop track that everyone will immediately like bob their heads to and like go, you know what I mean? Like, so it has to be like a new voice.
No, I can tell you from personal experience, it immediately caught, like the day it was out, Sharda and I think we started chatting about it the day it was out, and it was being shared around in the office and, you know, obviously everywhere else. It also, and I mean this in a good way, it also makes women's sport very sexy.
Yeah.
in the way that it's presented, and the fact that it makes it sexy to play sport.
Absolutely.
It's not just a grind, it's not just hard work, but it's fun as well. It hurts you, it pains you, but you have fun while doing it.
Yeah.
Was that an important messaging that you wanted out there?
We had that front and center. The three words that we always kept going back to was to make fun, sexy, and accessible. That was what we wanted this thing to do. That was what we wanted girls to feel about sport. And to us, the styling and the imagery was like really, really important. This is a job of correcting the image of sport. We're just getting started. You know, all this while, like you said, everything to do with sport imagery was about sweat and like intensity and ambition and like lofty words and like big language. We just wanted to like absolutely clean all of that. Darling, it just feels like a really accessible, I don't even know what it means, to be honest. We just came up with it. It actually came for the sound of the bell, ding, ding, ding. So we said, let's do it, Dara Ding. And let's make the girls look hot, you know, like let's make them look really nice. Let's get a stylist from Paris. Let's dress them up. Nike produces beautiful clothes. Why shouldn't they look good doing it? Why shouldn't every girl, the girls who've seen it, everyone is like, fuck, finally.
You can say it, no problem.
I mean, I think I have. But the point is, all the girls, the one thing we heard, and this is from girls from Melbourne, Amsterdam, London, New York, all over the world, they've all written to us and they said, finally, a sport that actually captures the spirit, not so much about Indian girls or whatever, the spirit of being a girl and playing and feeling strong. No one's actually captured that before.
Yeah, because this is a wonderful time to be reporting on women's sports women in sport in India. There's no such thing as women's sports, but women in sport in India, because, you know, we've had the athletes succeed so much at the Olympics. We've had other success stories over the last few years. Was that also integral to the fact that, you know, there are these exceptional role models now that exist in the Indian diaspora now, which young girls must relate to and must realize that there is, you know, there is a constituency of or a core group now of Indian sportswomen that are genuine role models?
So to be honest, when we were doing this, there weren't that many role models. I think after this, I think Sindhu won all the Olympics medals and the achievements came after this. And before that, and also we were not interested in role models that much as we were interested in the feeling of being able to play as a girl, of just going out and playing. We just didn't want to create any role models. We just wanted to tell every girl that you just go out and play, because once you play, you'll experience what it's like to actually sweat it out, and you'll feel so much more powerful and strong, and you can do anything with sport in your life. Sport was just missing, absolutely missing from their lives. Like I think someone this morning said that, you know, sweating is almost like a crime to some teachers in school. So it just baffles me, you know, that this still exists. So I mean, there was like massive problems at the ground level. But we did whatever we could to just give girls like a feeling of being superpowers in themselves. Yeah.
Did you have any trouble getting buy-ins from professional athletes on doing this work?
Not really. I think the good part about this was just everyone just felt so invested in it, because it was about girls. It was by girls for girls. We had like a creative team of like two girls who actually wrote the song, you know. So we just let them do whatever it is. Our aim was to create this killer sports squad of sorts, where you have like everyone from Deepika to like a lot of these girls are Nike runners and athletes,
right?
And they have their little run clubs in Bandra and like in other parts of Bombay, and there are some trainers who were in Bangalore. So we just got all of these girls together and we said, come, let's do this thing. And we had like, to be honest, the most interesting part of all of this was the casting. We spent 2 days in a room casting, I don't know, 100-150 girls. And the only rule of the casting thing was they should be actually able to play a sport. You can't fake it. Because if you fake it, it shows on camera, you lose the intensity straight up.
Right.
But, you know, especially when the two boxers came for casting, they were just like the sweetest girls, like just totally sweet and unassuming. They just came and they're like, oh, should I stand here? What should I do? And then we said, go. And they boxed the living hell out of each other. And we were like, what is going on here? You know what I mean? So that strength is pure, is authentic, and it's our responsibility to capture
Rizwan,
that.
Rizwan, clearly you've never met Mary Kom, because if you do, she's very, very nice to talk to, sitting next to her. But try and film one thing around her when she's boxing and just hear her punch someone, and you know, you don't want to be around this lady Yeah, when she's got her gloves
on. I'm not taking my chances on that. these two girls, anything to go by, especially.
Since we're talking about sports campaigns, I wonder if Nikhil could actually play. There was one other one. Unfortunately, Sanjay is not here with us. But this one also created an enormous resonance. And then we'll get Rizwan, Vishal to talk to everyone in the audience here. Just see this one.
देवकी मेरी माँ का नाम है।
कोई खास वजह?
मैं इतने साल से अपने पिता का नाम पहन रहा था, तब तो आपने कभी नहीं पूछा कि कोई खास वजह।
स्टार प्लस नई सोच।
This appealed at another emotional level.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
And of course, I mean, it was a great idea to start with. And there was a wonderful story which I think Jayant Yadav, the Indian cricketer, his mother had passed away in a plane crash. She was, I think, she tried to rescue some passengers. She was in the staff of Indian Airlines many, many years ago. And she passed away. So his dad remarried a few years later, and his stepmother brought them up, and the name that went up on the jersey was his birth mother's name. And he made the point in an interview at Vizag where this one day game was held with these jerseys in the on the shirts of the players, and he made the point that this, my mother's name is here, but mom, I really love you as well. And he addressed his mother back at home. So, you know, that was just a nice story that came out of this campaign as well. Well, anyway, Sanjay's not here, so we can't talk about this one too much. Unless, Rizwan, you have a view on this.
No, I just think, like, it's a beautiful touch. And I think it's great that brands are becoming more provocative in what they're saying. It's not just shallow messaging. I think all these different layers are, like, super important, because at the end of the day, advertising is part of pop culture. People watch it. People react to it. And if I think the whole marketing community has a lot to do when it comes to actually talking about real things, because I just feel like there's this shallow plastic layer of capitalism that's really sort of enveloping all aspects of our society now. And for Star to do something like this is really quite commendable.
Thank you so much to both of you guys for bringing this to us. We'll have our questions from the audience. As well. Nikhil, you have a question? No, I think you will be the last one to get the question. That's like total nepotism, man. Anyone in the audience with a question? Unless I have to go to Nikhil? Sharda, yes, please.
You can get a mic. Mic to Sharda.
I just wanted to ask you about what is your view on the kind of advertising around sport, not just women's sport, but sport normally is. Because what we normally see is, you know, you see cricketers selling colas and washing machines and inverters, and that doesn't really show their skill much, unlike the ad that you just showed, the Nike ad. So what is your general opinion of how, you know, whether the advertising industry has actually done the sporting abilities of our athletes any service by the way they've run these very popular campaigns, but largely, you know, colas and fridges and whatever?
Okay. So I don't know if I should be saying this, but like...
Yes, you should be.
With all due respect, cricketers don't need any more advertising support. You know, I think they get paid enough. There's enough, enough brands go on and endorse it. The narrative of, like, cricketers in popular culture, I think, is done. We have to, like, move on to, like, other sports people, male or female. We have to start creating new sort of narratives for sport in general. This is going back to my earlier point of how, like, marketing is just, like, so blind and just lazy, actually, to just cash in on whoever the next big sort of... this culture of celebrity is another thing that does my head in, because, again, it's very lazy and uninspired. So, broadly speaking, the state of sports advertising is also uninspired. And we need all the help we can get to sort of just create some new things.
So are you working on something as well?
I will continue to work on new and newer things. I think that's a personal mission, you know, like even Widen as an agency, we always try and say something new, whether we're selling, like, you know, we did this Old Spice campaign with Milan Soman, and that did rather well as well, because you were just so shameless about it, saying that, you know, like, it's just a deodorant. And can we have the actual man back, please? As opposed to...
I also auditioned for that.
I don't know who auditioned or, but I'm just saying, like, if
hey,
we don't
they
do...
They can't give it to guys who are, you know, like... okay.
But yeah, I mean, there's a broader purpose and broader sort of sense of introspection that needs to go out within the marketing community, and hopefully we can do a little bit to sort of facilitate that. But I hope I've kind of answered your question.
Yeah. Maybe they couldn't afford you, yeah, Vishal, after all your mauka mauka and all. You were
in a kaun sa question aa raha hai
different price point. Yes. 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 Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. My question is to Rizwan, sir. Sir, we've always seen ads featuring the mainstream stars, cricket stars, and now we have Sindhu and Sai Nehwal. So recently I came across a news that Indian hockey, ice hockey team, they don't have enough funds to go for a tournament. So now only 244 people have contributed around 3 lakh rupees. But if our franchises and owners of IPL teams can spend 14.5 crores on one guy for 2 months, don't you think we need more advertising agencies, advertising unsung heroes and teams that really need help, so then they can be brought into limelight and we can actually help them and allow our various teams from various sports to take part in international events and instead of them backing out?
No, I absolutely agree. I think that, in fact, I was... that's what I keep telling the guys at Nike, that, you know, making shiny ads is well and good, but I think the future of good advertising is actually meaningful advertising, right? Meaningful change on the ground and that story being told in marketing. And I think, again, because there's so much like marketing baggage around, that it takes a lot of effort and a lot of convincing for anyone across the board to actually change their old habits. And I think a lot of responsibility also lies in like creative directors of advertising agencies across the board to tell brands and clients to sort of stop looking this way and start looking this way and see who is the next big Sindhu or who is the next Sakshi Malik, because no one needs your help after they've actually gone ahead and sort of won their medals. After that, you give them a car ad. I think Sakshi Malik got a Beamer and she said, thanks, but no thanks.
No, Deepa did, because Deepa, she couldn't ride it in Agartala.
Yeah, so no, I think now BMW has learned it the hard way. So I just think that your point is like super valid, and we'll try and do whatever we can, but that makes sense.
So one more question, I mean, related to the same point.
But you didn't ask my permission.
Oh, sir, can I please?
No, please go ahead.
So when our cricket team wins a World Cup, we have the government... you know, like throwing surprise gifts at them, this voucher, that voucher, free ride and all that. So, but recently, and obviously they get new ads and stuff and they're featuring into ads and small campaigns. But recently, I think 2-3 months ago, when three of our Indian skaters won 3 gold medals at the Asian Championship, they weren't brought into the limelight. So, I mean, as a sports fanatic and a sports fan, it's my request. And it'll be great if we can also bring... And provided it's feasible and possible, if we can bring the unsung heroes also in the limelight, so everyone gets to know that what they've achieved.
I think Rizwan is on board with that. He's not going to work with any of the big stars. He's already told you that.
Thank you, sir.
So, yes, Snehal, you have a question, then Nikhil and we finish. Snehal. Snehal, by the way, is a former Indian cricketer. Finished playing in 2011.
Round of applause, please.
And
15.
Oh, I thought you...
No, I was playing domestic cricket.
Domestic cricket in 2000. International cricket in 2011. Yeah. And you can still bowl a mean Yorker.
Yeah, sure. So, again, with the Dada Ding ad, this is for Rizwan. Did you get any stories from Indian girls coming back at you saying that, wow, I saw this and I did this? Did you get any tangible movement on the ground, which is, you know, what you're looking at with these kind of ads?
We got a fair few, actually. One example is a little-known school in Coimbatore, actually. So a group of girls got together, and they actually defied the school authorities and formed a football team of their own. So now the school has sort of accepted the fact that they are going to play football in school. So now that school has their first girls football team in the history. It was really incredible, actually.
What was your reaction when you heard that?
Well, it's kind of humbling, to be honest. Because, you know, like, we sit in Delhi and we make these ads and we think we're all cool and all. But actually, when the proof of the pudding comes through, you're like, wow, people actually resonate with this. Because, you know, like, we also work under the operation, actually, it's just advertising, no one cares. But then when people write to you and tell you all these amazing stories that this ad has sort of inspired them to do, you really feel like you've done something, which is not a shabby feeling, actually.
He felt da-da-ding, I'm guessing.
The girls felt like they were doing something. So it was good, yeah.
Nikhil.
Okay, firstly, Rizwan, many congratulations. I've seen this gazillion times. Every time I see it, I get goosebumps. I don't know if everyone else, but every time I see the da-da-ding on YouTube or like I saw it here, I do get goosebumps. But my question is for Vishal, actually. Is there any truth to the fact that there was another campaign made while India was winning through that 2015 World Cup, and there was this one particular campaign made of the other team not getting a chance to celebrate? Was there another campaign made if India lost? Was there a backup?
We were shooting simultaneously. We shot for both, winning and losing.
So we never saw the losing one, I'm guessing.
They didn't.
You have the rushes? You have the raw footage?
I hear it's quite special.
I don't have the raw footage. You can ask the Star Sports. They have. And they were actually equally, and I would say few ads were more interesting than the winning ones.
How I wish we could see it. Finally, can I ask you another question?
Yeah, no.
Do you walk into, because this is something we were discussing over lunch, do you walk into shopping malls and someone calls you a Pakistani or something like that? Has it happened to you?
It happened. Not abhi to nahi, nothing.
Mooch hat gayi isliye.
Mooch I have in my movies also. They don't call me. You don't discriminate like this, okay? First of all.
Anyone? Oh, okay. We have two minutes. So yes, please go ahead. Please say clearly. Can you tell us your name? Who your question is for? Also.
Hi, my name is Revati. My question is to Mr. Rizwan. So we know that advertising as such has taken a hit ever since the digital space is dominating as such, because a lot of us don't watch television anymore, so hence we don't watch advertisements that much. But on the digital space, we wait for an opportunity to skip every ad possible. So how does advertising deal with this digital switch when everyone wants to just skip an ad to spend that extra 2 minutes on YouTube watching something else?
We are completely off topic, but go ahead.
Oh no, it's great. It's a very good question, actually. So the skip ad, I've never known two more words that have sort of been so fearful in advertising. You know, so we work with that fear that anyone's just going to click something and it's going to go. So the way to deal with that is to just make something interesting to begin with, something with a point, something new. And I know it sounds awfully simplistic, but that's the only thing. Now, if you keep swimming in cliches, no one's going to actually see what you've got to say. So the reason why da-da-ding worked was because of those things. We just said something very real, very authentic, something that was waiting to be said, something that was waiting to be shown, and something that people could connect with and felt compelled to share with other girls. If you don't create something that's worth sharing, you might as well go home. You know, that's the golden rule. That's just how we now live. This is the new reality. So you're right, and that's put incredible amount of pressure on brands and advertising agencies, more on advertising agencies than brands, because brands still live under the illusion that people will watch all 30 seconds of their ads. But it's pressure, and it's good pressure, and it's not going away. So we just have to come up with new things that hopefully you will like and share. That's the name of the game, really.
One last question I think we've got time for. I saw one hand go up in the back somewhere. Yes. Yes, you're the last one. Yeah, yeah. The girl with the Yes, please.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I had a question for Rizwan, sir. It's always said in advertising that you say client is king, right? And with Nike, you can expect ads that go offbeat and that address things that aren't conventional. But what happens when you want to make an ad as an agency that says something different and your client doesn't want to do it because it risks their brand image or something like that? How do you deal with telling a different story and convincing your client that you should actually tell this story?
I think to begin with, we wouldn't do anything that would sort of risk the brand's image to begin with. I think the reason brands work with agencies is because agencies have like a really innate understanding of their brand. Well, at least they should. So I think point number one is we will never do anything that will risk their image. The second thing, which is the everyday struggle of a good sort of writer slash creative director or agency, is that how do you sell really good work that forces clients to sort of stick their neck out a bit. I think there are enough ways and means of doing it, but I think the most powerful tool here is just like logic. That's why like agencies hire so many people to, so that someone in the room can come up with a logical sort of argument to why the brand or the client should be doing this. And you know, like finally God helps those who help themselves. So if brands see the sort of logic and merit in the work that agencies sort of sees and decides to sort of do it, then you get things like da-da-ding. But if brands would play it safe and are not willing to sort of be a bit more refreshing or new with their approach, then I think, honestly, it makes no difference to either brand or agency because the things just keep sort of rolling on. And you press the skip ad button, people change channels, the world continues to revolve and makes no difference to anyone. So you have to decide whether you want to be in a partnership where you make difference to absolutely no one, or you want to be in a partnership where people actually talk about you and commend you for whatever it is you're doing in whatever little way.
Thank you so much, guys. If any of you guys are, if this goes up on YouTube, the advice to anyone watching, all your friends, is please don't skip the ad. Watch it in full.
Please
then
don't.
Hear the discussion. Thank you, Rizwan. And also, Vishal, for coming all the way from Pakistan to make this happen.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah? No, I am a global traveler. I have a global passport, na. Just not Pakistan. And for this thing, also one more thing. Yeah, you are saying ki aise, to clashes are there, na? By the way, when we shoot, to clashes are there between the director, producer, production agency, and the client. Or sabke ideas mismatch hote hain, kuch match nahi kar paate. Fir wo ये लोग बताते हैं डायरेक्टर को ऐसे करना है, डायरेक्टर से इसको ज्यादा पता ये कर लो, इसको देनी नहीं एडिट, या अपने आप एडिट में काटता रहेगा, प्रोफेस लो, चलो माँ की आंख जाए, दे वर्क लाइक दैट.
अरे चलो, वी लेट द एक्टर्स हैव अ बिट ऑफ द लास्ट वर्ड. लेट द एक्टर हैव द लास्ट वर्ड. यस, थैंक यू विशाल, कांग्रेचुलेशंस, ग्रेट वर्क. यू शुड बी वेरी प्राउड ऑफ दैट एंटरटेनमेंट यू प्रोवाइडेड एवरीवन. रिजवान, थैंक यू वेरी मच. थैंक यू. थैंक यू.
गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल. यार, थैंक यू.
Now for the final session of the day, could I have, I ask please